Welcome back to the second half of our concert. We certainly hope you have enjoyed our performance at this point. We continue with a piece that embodies the same grandeur and courage that our fellow heroes have displayed in their times of battle. Thank you. That last selection was a romantic and heroic composition, Resplendent Glory by Rossano Galante, conducted by Major Michael Horber. The next joyful classic, you will hear conversations that are similar to what you would hear at veteran reunions. They remember the highs, the lows, and the unique bond between service members that time cannot break. Written for the classic musical White Christmas, G.I. Wish I Was Back in the Army, depicts the scene where the musical's protagonists entertain the reunion of the 151st Division. Please join us in welcoming Chief Warrant Officer Matthew David to the stage to conduct Gee, I Wish I Was Back in the Army by Erling Barin, featuring Staff Sergeant Justin Smith, Staff Sergeant Kristen Crawford, Sergeant Kristen Flagg, and Specialist Kira McLean.
Without a doubt, that I'd be through with all my cares and strife.
Back when I was then,
hey,
the happiest of men,
hey.
But after months of tough civilian life,
whoop-dee-doo, whoop, gee, I wish I was back in the army. The army wasn't really bad at all. 3 meals a day, for which you didn't pay. Uniforms for winter, spring, and fall. There's a lot to be said for the army.
A life without responsibility. A soldier out of luck was never really stuck. There's always somewhere higher up where you can pass the buck.
Oh gee, it's great to be back in the army.
Handsome guys with longing in their eyes, and all you have to do is fake the age, the weight, the size.
Oh gee, I wish I was back in the army. Gee, I wish I was back in the army.
The shows we got civilians couldn't see. How they would yell,
hey, hey!
For Dietrich and Cornell, Jolson, Hope, and Benny, all for free.
There's a lot to be said for the army. The best of doctors watched you carefully. A dentist and a clerk, for weeks and weeks they'd work. They'd take $1,000 gun and give it to a jerk.
Oh gee, I wish I was back in the army.
I wish I was back in the army now. Ten Hut.
Thank you all for that wonderful performance. It was a joy to watch and listen to, but you know what? I think I'll stick with the Navy. In all conflicts, many of our deployed service members have trusted in a higher power that they will return home to their loved ones. In the past, service members sent love letters home. Today, we are fortunate to have the technology which allows communication by social media, text, or even video chat with our loved ones. All the Things You Are by Jerome Kern and Oscar Hammerstein, as sung by Ella Fitzgerald, calls to mind the loving correspondence between service members and their families during deployments and temporary duty apart. Please enjoy this arrangement of All the Things You Are, performed by Specialist Kira McLean.
The lonely winter seem long. You are the restless hush of evening that trembles on the brink of a lovely song. You are the angel glow
At the end of every deployment, each service member anxiously awaits that final trip home. Returning to our family and friends is filled with so much love and joy. At this time, we would like to invite all military family members to stand and be recognized and thank for their unwavering support of their service members. Without you, we would not be able to do the jobs that are set out before us to defend our country. This next selection, Happy Days Are Here Again, sung by Specialist Kira McLean, is a celebration. Whether pier side, on a military installation tarmac, or civilian airport, of the joyous family reunions that every service member looks forward to. Ladies and gentlemen, can we get another round of applause for our fantastic 25th Infantry Division singers? Our next selection, Inchon, is a musical work by Robert W. Smith. Smith was inspired by the historic event that changed the tide of the Korean War in 1950. From the quiet sound of the waves on the lonely Korean beach to the landing of the helicopter on Hill 812, Inchon explores this clashing of cultures through sound. The work is dedicated in loving memory of the composer's father, Staff Sergeant Benjamin F. Smith, United States Army, a heroic veteran of the Korean and Vietnam conflicts. 69 years later, our relations with the Republic of Korea and Vietnam have changed drastically. Today, we have had collaborative musical performances with musicians from the Republic of Korea, as well as side-by-side humanitarian and military exercises with Vietnam that have strengthened the relationships between all the countries involved in these special events. Please welcome to the stage Chief Warrant Officer Curtis Hyane to conduct as we honor our Korean War veterans with Inchon by Robert W. Smith.
Thank you.
During World War I and World War II, upwards of 450,000 women served at home and abroad as mechanics, ambulance drivers, pilots, administrators, nurses, and in other non-combat roles. 88 women were captured and held as prisoners of war, and over 400 died in the line of duty. This selfless service to country continues today as our soldiers, sailors, airmen, Coast Guardmen, and Marines answer the nation's call. The band's next selection was composed in 1985 to honor all women who have served their country in the armed forces and the heroic achievements of our military as a result. The composer Mark Camphouse creates musical moments that depict the harshness and bitterness of war, provide an opportunity for us to reflect on the sacrifices of those who have gone before us, and sends us off with a thrilling conclusion as we celebrate the triumph of hard-fought victory. Please welcome back Warrant Officer Steve Talbot as he conducts tribute by Mark Camphouse.
Thank you.
Over the last four decades, composer David Maslanka has become one of America's most original and celebrated musical voices. He characterized his hymn for world peace as follows. Given the complexity of world problems, this may seem like a naive and even simple-minded idea. Yet peace has to begin somewhere, and the reality is that it has to start in each one of us. We dedicate this closing selection to those who have served or are currently serving this Armed Forces Day. Without the dedication and sacrifice of our active duty personnel and veterans, peace and prosperity in the Pacific would not be possible. Please welcome back to the stage, Lieutenant Kelly Cartwright.
Thank you.
As we conclude our concert, we would like to take this opportunity to honor all those who have served or are currently serving this armed force today. For those who are able, when you hear your service song, please stand so we can salute you.
Thank you.